purpose of today's like discussion really is given that Nelson was keen to have an event to mark February 4th and to utilise his visit here to Sydney, not just to do the official ceremony, but also allow us to have a good discussion with Nelson about the situation in Venezuela today, particularly in light of the elections coming up in October. And hopefully that could help us to be up to date, ask any questions that we might have about the situation in Venezuela, but also perhaps frame a bit of the solidarity work we might want to do with Venezuela this year. And Nelson already has a few projects that he's got underway or has plans for projects for solidarity activities, which I'm sure he can fill us in on. But perhaps, yeah, maybe to kick us off, if you wanted to give a bit of an introduction about the situation at the moment in Venezuela and the perspectives towards the elections. Well, Nelson's asking as well if people would like us to talk a little bit about February 4. I'm not sure if everyone knows, is up to date about February 4, or if would like to have it hear from Nelson a little bit more about the actual events of February 4 and what it meant for Venezuela. So.
Hay algunos hechos importantes para ver la significación del 4 de febrero.
I think it's useful to begin talking about February 4 because there's a number of important events or actions that occurred that help explain a little bit more about February 4.
Porque previo al 4 de febrero, entre el año 89 y 92 se dio toda la etapa de organización del 4 de febrero.
Because prior to February 4, basically from between 1989 to 1992, there was a whole period of organizing to prepare for the military rebellion.
El 4 de febrero es el momento en que aparece público el movimiento bolivariano.
February 4 was like the first public appearance of the Bolivarian movement.
Pero desde el año 88 se venía trabajando con la Fuerza Armada para provocar el 4 de febrero.
But basically from about 1988 there was already people organizing to prepare for something like what occurred on February 4.
No es solamente un movimiento militar.
And it wasn't just a military movement.
Sino que había civiles involucrados en esa actividad.
But there was also civilians involved in that activity.
Por supuesto, todo eso dentro de toda una cobertura clandestina para poder generar esas reuniones.
Of course, all of those meetings had to be organized underground.
Y varios movimientos civiles estaban armados, estaban participando con los militares para promover este alzamiento militar.
And there were various armed civilian groups that were working with sections within the military to prepare the rebellion.
Y por ejemplo el hermano de Hugo, Adán Chávez, era parte del PRB.
For example, Hugo Chávez's brother, Adán Chávez, was part of the PRV, the Party of the Venezuelan Revolution.
Y formó el vínculo y la relación entre el PRB, que era un movimiento armado, civil, bueno, civil-militar, y lo que era la Fuerza Armada Oficial, pues, ¿no?
And he was basically a point of contact between those that were in the civilian armed group and those that were operating within the military.
Y también otros grupos armados civiles de Venezuela participaban con los militares, pues, ¿no?
And there were also other armed civilian groups that were meeting with sections of the military.
Y durante el año, cuando se produce el Caracazo, fue el momento, bueno, que obligó a tomar una decisión.
And the Caracazo very much was an event that obliged those that were preparing this rebellion to take a decision and to carry it out.
Es decir, los que estábamos ahí en el año 89, realmente era sorprendente ver cómo mataban a la gente en la calle. O sea,
because for many of us who were there in 1989, it was, you know, a huge surprise to just see how they were basically massacring people on the streets.
La policía y el ejército matando a la gente en la calle. Sí.
The people in the army just literally just killing people on the streets.
O sea, fue dramático ese momento histórico para nosotros. Pero
it was a very dramatic historical moment for us.
Fueron tres días de represión y de de asesinato.
It was 3 days of repression and assassinations.
Y ese fue el momento en que se logró, bueno, entre los civiles y los militares decir, bueno, que hay que hacer algo.
Now it was a moment really when both the civilian groups and the groups within the military said it's time to act, we need to do something.
Y que la vía no podía ser electoral, no había capacidad para organizar un movimiento electoral.
And the path was not to go to elections, it just wasn't the capacity to organize an electoral movement.
Porque la mayor capacidad estaba era en la parte militar.
Because the biggest strength we had was the strength we had in the military.
Y porque afortunadamente estaban en los puestos de comando oficiales patriotas que venían reuniéndose con nosotros.
Because luckily we had a number of officials who were commanders that were meeting as part of this group within the military to plan the rebellion.
Estaba Arias Cárdenas, Urdaneta, Chirino, Chávez.
So we had Arias Cárdenas, Urdaneta, Chirinos, Chávez.
Y ya que ellos tenían la capacidad militar, entonces se logró promover ese golpe, o rebelión militar, la llamamos nosotros, más que golpe.
And because they had that military capacity was why they decided to carry out the coup, what we refer to as a military rebellion.
Y había varios momentos para provocar esa rebelión.
And there was various moments that occurred that provoked that rebellion.
Desde octubre del 91, ya había varias fechas para provocar esa rebelión.
As of October 91, there was already a number of dates that were part of provoking this rebellion.
Y se optó por la fecha del 4.
And the date, the 4th of February, was chosen.
Porque ya en ese momento, ese día iba a llegar el presidente Carlos Andrés Pérez.
Because that was the day that the then President Carlos Andrés Pérez was going to arrive back.
Que venía de una reunión en Suiza.
He had just been in a meeting in Switzerland.
Y la idea era tomarlo preso cuando el avión aterrizara.
And so the idea was basically to take him prisoner when his plane landed.
Pero en todo esto siempre hay situaciones no previstas, pues.
But of course, in any time planning an event like this, always events that you didn't take into consideration occur.
Porque desde el día 3 de febrero.
Because as of the 3rd of February,
el movimiento militar fue delatado. Un oficial que estaba participando en el movimiento,
one of the officials that was participating in the movement,
delató a los altos mandos militares de ese golpe, de esa rebelión militar.
Alerted the military high command of the impending rebellion.
Entonces, por eso es que algunas unidades militares no pudieron participar en el movimiento.
And that's why some of the military units weren't able to participate in the rebellion.
Por ejemplo, la unidad de tanques que está en el Ministerio de la Defensa en el Fuerte Tiuna.
For example, the unit of tanks that's based in Fuerte Tiuna, where the Ministry of Defense was.
A todos los tanques le desactivaron los mecanismos de comunicación.
All of those tanks had their communications disarmed.
Entonces no podían salir, pues.
So of course they couldn't leave the fort.
Y fueron detenidos algunos oficiales.
And a number of those officials were detained.
Y eso obligó al presidente Chávez, que estaba en Maracay, que una ciudad cercana a Caracas.
And this forced Chávez, who at the time was in Maracay, a city close to Caracas,
movilizar todos sus batallones para tomar Miraflores.
To mobilize all of the battalions there to take over the presidential palace, Miraflores.
Y por su parte, en otros estados, los otros oficiales tenían que tomar control de esos estados.
And from their part, the officials that were based in other states had to also mobilize their units to take control of those states.
Y por lo menos Arias Cárdenas, el comandante Arias Cárdenas, tomó todo el estado Zulia.
For instance, Arias Cárdenas, commander at the time, took over, or the rebellion there, headed the rebellion to take over the state of Zulia.
trancaron el puente sobre el lago Maracaibo y tomaron todas las instalaciones petroleras.
They blocked off the bridge across the Lake Maracaibo and also took over the installations of the oil company there.